15 or you'll regret it. Progressive Group Move On now making a new push for $15 minimum wage, using a different twist here, a very strong word. Low wages are violence. Think of that. Knowingly letting people suffer is violence, and it must end. The former CKE restaurant CEO Andy Puzner on what he makes of that. What do you make of that?
Well, Neil, good to see you. Well, number one, violence is violence. This is not violence. When you agree to pay somebody the going wage in an agreement between the employer and the employer to do a job, that's called employment. It's not called violence. And to try and make employment or entry-level jobs, trying to turn those into violent acts, really shows a level of desperation even the SEIU has not, or MoveOn.org, have not come up with before. This is it's a new low, and it's an attempt to distort the English language, the economics, and the way that you and I got started in our business lives, entry-level jobs.
You know what? I wonder whether this might be code or something else, that workers shouldn't settle for anything less than $15 an hour, and if it means taking it to the next level, so be it.
You know, look, right now there are 440,000 job openings in manufacturing. There are 300,000 job openings in transportation, which are truck drivers. Another 250,000 job openings in construction, which indicates significant economic growth. You can't drive by a restaurant that doesn't have a sign out there trying to hire people for $10, $11, $12 an hour, well in excess of the minimum wage. The economy is making the MoveOn.org and the SEIU irrelevant. If people want jobs, there are jobs. You can find jobs. There are more job openings than there are unemployed people. That's happened 3 months in a row. It's the first time it's ever happened. I don't know what these people are trying to do other than trying to establish some relevance for themselves as economic growth makes them increasingly irrelevant.
You know, I'd flip it around, though, Andy, of that if the higher wages that went into effect in so many states, not always $15, but definitely higher than where we were, and you mentioned 11 or 12, which is increasingly more the minimum average, and it was supposed to be so deleterious to the economy, it hasn't, right? We're at full employment plus record low unemployment levels for kids, for minorities of all sorts, women. So maybe the higher minimum wage thing, to MoveOn's point, isn't nearly as damaging. What do you think?
Look, these $11 and $12 wages are being driven by economic growth. They're not, the government, the states haven't taken minimum wages up to that level. On the way here, I saw an $11 an hour sign. I'm in Tennessee. The minimum wage is $7.25. The minimum wage increase was irrelevant to this. It's economic growth that drove that and competition for employees. When we have employees competing with each other for jobs, as we did in the Obama administration, wages don't go up, and mandating a dramatic minimum wage increase like $15 an hour kills jobs, lowers incomes, hurts businesses, and hurts the very employees they claim to be trying to help.
Think about it, my friend. The higher wages, and we're not talking $15 here, but closing in on it, in the national scheme of things, where people are getting jobs left and right, and some jobs, to your point, go begging, that's even with the higher rate. So you could make a credible argument that it's not done the damage that some feared.
As long as economic growth drives wages up, as long as it's businesses doing more business, bringing more money in, and being able to distribute that to employees through lower taxes, less regulation, more revenue coming in, lower expenses, as long as that's driving wages up, you don't have the deleterious effects. You don't have the job killing, automation, and all the things that come in when you compel businesses to raise wages in a low economic growth era, like the Obama era, where it never really got above 2%. Well, we're well above that now, and it's driving wages up, and people aren't losing jobs, and they aren't seeing their incomes diminish. We're having just the opposite effect. So this is what, you know, people like me were arguing all through the Obama administration. Let the economy fix
all
it.
Right.
You know, let them drive wages. Let business people do what business people do, which is grow and create jobs.
All right. Andy, I'm always suspicious of you anyway, because you worked in fast food all your life, and you're thin as all get at. So I don't know. Always good seeing you, my friend. Thank you very,
good
very much.
You, pal. Thanks.
Andy Puzner, and he doesn't have an ounce of fat.